So then coming to the classroom sizes. So how the classroom size can be decided? So here we can see we have taken three categories. So 0.9 meter square per student or pupil of primary school. Here primary school means we should consider lower primary, okay, up to 5th standard. So higher primary means 5th, 6th and 7th, we can say like this. And higher school or high school or secondary school, we can take it as 8th, 9th and 10th standard students. So for lower primary school, we have standardized that per student requires 0.9 meter square of area. For a student who is in or who is in his or her higher primary, that is 5th, 6th and 7th, so that student requires as a standard 1.11 meter square of area. And for high school student, they require 1.2 to 1.5 meter square of area. So according to this, the classroom should be decided. So per pupil, check the area how much he or she occupies. Check how many number of students are to be accommodated in the classroom. Multiply these two so that we will get the total area. And not only this to be considered, we should also consider the furniture area, should also consider the different aspects in the classroom also. So all these aspects together or all these subject together, we should consider the total area of the classroom. So then coming to the width and length of the classroom. So width of the classroom for effective teaching, it should be 6 meter. And the length of the classroom, it should not be more than 9 meter. So minimum classroom size. So in this minimum classroom size, we have again taken two categories. That is for primary school with furniture and middle school and higher secondary school with furniture. So primary school means I am telling lower primary up to 5th standard. So up to 5th standard, if we want to construct the classroom, so standard size can be taken as 6.1 by 7.3 meter as you can see there. And for higher primary or middle school, okay, higher primary or middle school you can take, that is 5th, 6th and 7th standard. And higher school or high school or secondary school, so the size will be 6.8 meter by 7.3 meter. So then coming to the assembly room or multi-purpose room, that is we can say it as auditorium hall, right? We are having auditorium hall, those big halls in our school that used to be there. So those are called auditorium halls or assembly hall. So that like the same, why? Because the multi-purpose room has been named there, because that auditorium can be used for indoor games. That same auditorium can be used for conducting different programs or cultural activities there. The same auditorium or the assembly hall can be used for prayer, because in monsoon season, in rainy season, we cannot go and stand there in rain in the ground for prayer. So the prayers will be done inside the auditorium hall itself. So this will be multi-purpose hall. The auditorium or the assembly hall will be multi-purpose hall. So according to that itself, we need to plan the size of that auditorium hall. So as a standard, we can see here, the minimum length is 20 meter given to an auditorium or an assembly hall or a multi-purpose hall. And excluding the stage, so the width will be of 9 meter. Okay, the length will be standardized at 20 meter minimum length, and the minimum width is 9 meter excluding the stage. So the stage parameters, the length and width, leave it. Apart from that, stage dimensions, the length and the width should be 20 meter and the 9 meter respectively. So this is how we have to consider the different features of the design when we are going for the planning of the classroom. In the next videos, we will discuss about the next public buildings. Thank you.